We depend on computers for everything nowadays. They keep a story of our lives, our pictures, our videos, our contacts, our schedules. Now just imagine if all that went away. Imagine if you try to turn on your computer and you get nothing. Everything is gone. In this video, I'm going to show you some steps on how to reduce that risk. The first step to take into account is to prepare for the worst, which means backing up your data. And here's some pros and cons of how to do that. The first option is through CDs or DVDs. These are cheap, they have decent read-write speeds, and they can store up to 50 gigabytes on Blu-rays. Now the cons is that they're easy to damage and they also have poor burn accuracy the faster you burn them. The next option is through flash drives. These are durable and portable. They have fast read-write times, but the cons is that they have small storage size and that the larger storage size you want, the more expensive they're going to be. Next option is through hard drives. These are the most popular. They have large storage sizes, fast read-write times, and they also have RAID options available. But the cons is that they're very fragile and they can wear down pretty easily over time. The last option is like a mix between hard drives and flash drives. They're solid state drives. They have fast read-write times, durable, and not likely to wear down over time. And yet, they're expensive and they don't have large storage sizes available yet. To defragment your hard drive means you're taking fragments of data and putting them in one easy to access place on your hard drive. How does this help your hard drive's performance? I'll show you. This represents a defragmented hard drive where all the data is in one space. It's easy to retrieve. Now on a fragmented hard drive, the data is spread out, so the hard drive has to do a lot more work to retrieve all of it. To run a defragmentation on your hard drive, just go to Start, go to Accessories, then go to System Tools, and there should be a Disk Defragmenter option. It looks different in Vista and XP, but both of them allow you to set the defragmenter on a schedule or go ahead and defragment your hard disk if it needs it. The third step to take into account is monitoring your hard drive's health. And the best way to do this is with software, and there's some free options available out there. So just do a Google search for HDD health, and it should bring up a result that goes to PenteraSoft.com. And at the bottom of their page, you should see a link to their free HDD health application. Then you can just download it and install it, and it should automatically run. And what it's going to do is it's going to tell you the approximate health and temperature of your hard drive so that you can kind of keep an eye on what's going on with it. And as you can see, mine's a little bit high in the temperature range, 49 degrees Celsius. And it also gives you information about the partition space on your hard drive and your system itself. And what you can do with this information is go to File and Options and have it alert you if this information gets too critical. And that way you can keep an eye on the status of your hard drive and your partition space and if it starts getting out of hand. Now, another cool application that you can either run instead of this or along with this is at hddscan.com. And it's another free application that you can download. So just download and save it to your computer, and it'll save a zip file. And what you want to do is just extract everything that's in that zip file, and you'll find an hddscan.exe application. Just double click on that to run it, and this is what the program is going to look like. And what you can do is click on the Smart button, and it's going to give you a breakdown that you can either save to a file or print. And it gives you all the information on your hard drive, and as you can see, it's got little exclamation points about the temperature. But you can save this and kind of benchmark your hard drive status. The best way to make sure that your computer is running cool is by making sure that it stays clean. Now this means getting rid of any obstructions that may be in the fans or getting rid of any dust bunnies that may be lurking around. There's a couple different ways to do this. Most people seem to prefer using a can of compressed air. Basically what you want to do with this is spray it inside the computer fans or computer grills,
and getting rid of any obstructions that might be hindering performance and hindering the computer from keeping itself cool. Now, the only problem with using a can of compressed air is that it tends to disperse the dust as opposed to completely getting rid of it. So a method I prefer is using just a regular vacuum cleaner extension like this and just getting rid of all the dust and dust particles and dust bunnies in one fell swoop. This is probably the best method to go when cleaning out your computer.
Now, there's several different ways of increasing the life of your hard drive, some of which I didn't even touch on. So if you have any comments or extra tips, feel free to leave those at the tinkernut.com forums. And for more tutorials, go to tinkernut.com.